how to set your kickouts right here from the operator station. So we're going to reach over to our soft touch button panel where we're greeted with a set your tilt, set your lower, and set your upper position. Now, before we program these, we're going to put the linkage in the desired position. So for the lower, I'm going to set a level bucket attachment, and I'm going to set it just a few inches above ground so I can save those cutting edges. And I'm going to memorize that position. And I do that by doing a 1 second, 2 second push and hold on the tilt kickout. Same thing for the lower, 2 seconds, 1 second, 2 second, push and hold. Memorize my lower position. Now the last, the upper. So let's raise it to that truck or that hopper or that trench or that feed wagon, whatever it might be. And let's now, when it's in the upper position, push and hold, 1 second, 2 second, memorized my upper position. Now let me manually lower this back down, and I'm gonna go through a full cycle using those kickouts. So max engine RPM, I'm gonna manually rack in. Notice the snubbing or the dampening characteristic of the machine. Now pull it into the upper kickout position. So up it goes, and when it gets there, just like on rack, it's gonna electronically snub or dampen out. Now let me manually dump the bucket over, and I'm gonna recall two positions at once, level attachment and lower, and it's gonna go back to that pre-programmed level and lower attachment just a few inches above ground. And that's our coaching to you, to set that attachment just a few inches above ground so you don't prematurely scrub your cutting edges or your forks on your approach to that pile or to that pallet. Let it hover above to the last minute and then dive it down. Now notice that we have set those while we have the bucket recalled. We can actually toggle onto that bucket, and we could change attachments, in this example, to a fork, and I could reset those for a fork. Or I could reach over and toggle to another attachment, like a broom, a hydromechanical, and I could reset those for that. And as you recall those different attachments, those kickouts are gonna go with. We can also use the navigation button down here as we navigate to a range of attachments. So as I cycle through them, fork, now rotary, and back again, bucket, fork, and rotary. Now those three can be switched out for the most popular three that you're using, but they're recalling the individual kickouts that you've used when you've programmed them. Really simple way to both set and to recall relative to the attachment that you're using. Next gen small loader, setting the kickouts right here from the operator station.